move the shadow, please? This way.
Yeah, go on back.
Over that way, thanks.
Here we are back with the two gentlemen involved in the playoff, Greg Norman and Lee Westwood. Greg to play first.
Well, there's the shot he's got. He's behind the trees. He's got a good lie though, but the only thing is when you it's a difficult thing when you can't see the flag. It's sort of a bit off-putting, just trying to get the right line. So he'll pick a spot on the top of those trees and say, well, that's the line I've got to hit it on. I know I've got the right club, and go ahead and hit it.
...113 to the front, 137 to the flag. Just a wedge for Greg.
Westwood, on the other hand, a clear look forward to the flag.
Westwood with wedge, 136 metres. Perfect angle. It's fading back to the flag. It's right down the pipe. It looks, if it's up, it's good.
Well, if you're going to on one side or the other, that's the better one. Be short, particularly with your opponent in sand and in trouble. He may not have seen Greg Norman hole out of sand as often as we have over the years down in Melbourne. But advantage the Northern Hemisphere at the moment. Of course, if you look back earlier this year, we're talking of playoffs, Greg Norman, he lost in Dubai to Richard Green in the Dubai Desert Classic. Then back in May, he lost to Mark James in a playoff in the Spanish Open. So he can do without the Europeans and the European events and things for playoffs.
If is a marvellous word, Craig Parry knows all about that. If we go back earlier in the afternoon, he had this opportunity on 15. You got the feeling, Jack, that if he sank this...
Yeah, well, I said at the time that he couldn't afford to take a bogey post a score. And at the time, everybody at home probably thought I was going mad, but stranger things have happened in this game. Now, this is no easy shot for Norman because he's run all the way out to the other side of the trap, as you can see. If he was a bit closer, it wouldn't be a difficult shot at all. He hasn't got a lot of green to work with, and we saw, I think, was it Nick Ahern in there earlier? And, no, I don't know that it was, but somebody was in here earlier, and it's not an easy shot. It slides away from you right to left. But we've seen him play some wonderful trap shots. He's going to open the face right up. He wants plenty of spin on this. 9 smooth swing and just slide the sand on under the ball. Good shot. Very good shot. Showed plenty of ticker. Plenty of heart. Still a bit of work to do, mind yes. you.
And of course, there's that doubt in Westwood's mind that he might hole it, he might not. It's not certain. But again, Lee Westwood left with a pretty long putt. At least he's had one go on this green already today, and he'll taste it. But as you were saying, Jack, it's a faster green than any of the others. It's just set up a little bit, and it slopes from front down towards the back. So whereas Norman has got a probably, if anything, an uphill putt. Pace. is the difficult thing to judge here, and that hasn't really been his strong suit this afternoon. I think he'll be happy to we can get this stone dead and see if Norman can hold me prepared to go down 18 if not.
Yeah, well, he hit a very good putt at the last. He got that the pace right there, and the heat was on. Now Worm's Eye View. This to win the Australian Open. No. Very good try.
Started to come back again, didn't it?
Yeah, it was a double breaker, wasn't it? Went from right to left to start with, and then it was trying to work back to the hole from the left.
Good putt there. Very good putt.
Now up to Greg. He needs this putt to stay in the race for the 97 title.
Now the key to trying to hold putts like this under the gunner is try and keep the tension out of your hands. A couple of deep breaths. And then try and don't choke the putter.
The way Jackie saved the crucial putts today has been really one of the features of his game.
Absolutely. I think you'll get it. As soon as you choke the club under pressure, it makes you jerk the putter back and invariably you miss it left. Norman needs this putt to go up the 18th.
The playoff continues.
Terrific up and down from Norman.
So let's have a closer look, Jack, at this 18th, 433-metre par 4.
Well, it's a tough hole. 433 metres is a mean par 4 in anyone's language. The bunker's on the right, 224 to the start of them, 266 to carry that last bunker on the right. And you've really got to stay out of that second one because with the lip on it, you just can't reach the green. Trouble left. Uphill second shot, feature by this big trap on the left. Pin over on the left today. Not playing anything like its length with what breeze there is at the players' backs. We've seen Greg Norman hit a 7-iron in here just some 20 minutes ago. Just 7 birdies though all day, averaging 4.2. You can see on the flag there in the left of our corner on the breeze from the left. So the tee shot's here crucial. I should tell you that they would have tossed on the 17th. That's why Greg Norman had the honour.
Driver for Greg, and this one's put in the fairway again. Perfect.
Yes, if anything, a little bit further left than last time, but another very good drive.
Just a reminder to our viewers on the Seven Network, staying with the golf till we have a winner. Crossing to news commitment. So the news following the golf.
Well, Lee Westwood does not want to go where he went the first time. He was very fortunate to come up with a good lie. And if you go left, you really take luck in your own hands because quite often you'll come up with a scrubby lie over there and it makes getting four very difficult. See if he can do a bit better this time.
Yeah, they really cut the rough in here, Jack, on this hole this year. Started down the left side. It's fading back to the middle of the fairway. Absolutely perfect, alongside with Greg. And I've got to say that you've got to hand it to Greg Norman on the last there. That was a big up and down for par.
Westwood's ball just trickling into that wispy light rough.
24-year-old handling himself extremely well against the 42-year-old world number one. A reminder, of course, about our top flight competition. You've still got time if you want to be a winner, because we've given away some fabulous prizes. Two sets of top flight tour golf clubs to go today, starting with the Intimidator driver, the 3-wood, the 5-wood. Then we've got the irons, the 9 stainless steel perimeter weighted tour irons. The bag, valued at $450, and a dozen Strata Tours. Top Flight's multi-layered golf ball. Fantastic prize, valued at over $2,500 to be a winner. Or the chance of winning, just ring this number, 0055-60490. 0055-60490. Lines are open now, so go to it. And our thanks to Top Flight. And that young lady has a major interest in this playoff, because that is Laurie, who is the girlfriend and fiance, in fact, of Lee Westwood. I think they were going to get married earlier on, weren't they, Bruce?
That's right, around Masters time, but he got the invitation to that and hasn't found time since to tie the knot, so to speak.
Might find time if he's successful here.
Well, he's thinking of other things. I remember back around the time he won the Volvo Masters, which is now about a month ago. And he said to his manager, he said, if I win 3 tournaments, including this one, he said, I'll buy myself an aeroplane. Well, he went away and won the Tejeo Masters as well. So, still think, depending on this day and age, you'll still only have the deposit for it, I think, even if he does win.
Yeah, well, of course, Laurie's Andrew Coulthard's sister, who finished 6th himself.
A fairly good week for the family.
So they'll be brothers-in-law.
That's right.
The master of the family tree.
Once again, as you were saying, Jack, the crowd allowed to walk up in orderly fashion. Of course, that was for many years a feature of the British Open Championship. And until it became a little bit overdone, I remember at Birkdale, when Tom Watson won there back in 1983. Been a fine achievement, as you keep harping on the fact he's only 24 years of age, and great experience to sample something like this at this age and win, lose or draw. He's going to have benefited from it. The importance, he hasn't played terribly well today, but he's hung in there, and was around when Norman let him through.
There are friends watching it on the big screen, giving themselves a wave, and why not? Great way to watch the golf, isn't it?
Now, although Lee Westwood's just off the fairway, you can see he's got a much better angle at the flag, being on the right. Pin, remember, over on the left. So he's got a better angle to attack this flag.
Once again, the prime job, put it on the green and put the pressure back on the opponent.
Notice he puts the club in first, then takes his stance.
Drawing back to the flag. Looks a good shot. If it's the right length, it's perfect. Now he caught it a little heavy. It's on the front of the green. It's rolling back off the green. The door is ajar for Greg Norman right here.
Well, Lockie just caught that a bit heavy. And that's no bargain to get that up and down either. I'd rather see Greg Norman make a 3 here and win it that way.
Win in style.
So the effect of the breeze in the last half hour since we were back here, Greg's drive's 20 metres longer, 149 to the flag this time. Looks to be only a 9-iron. This a little right, but not as far right as the other one. Stay there. It's got to stay on the bank.
No,
it's coming back.
It's not far away, but it's a very difficult putt because there's a little step between the ball and the hole. But of course, there's no doubt as to which would be the happier one.
There's Laurie watching her fiance's ball in flight, feeling the pressure.
Yes, they always say it's far harder to watch than to actually be out there doing it.
Once again, they have the luxury of strolling up the 18th to this wonderful ovation. What a magnificent finish it's been to this year's Holden Australian Open. And it's not over yet.
Yes, yeah, very much role reversal to the previous hole. The onus now on Westwood to get down in two. And even if he does, Norman has a chance to win with a good putt of his own.
You can see Lee Westwood's ball just trickling off the back off the front of the green. So he's down this end, almost just got to skirt that bunker. And as we get around to the side, you can see the tier that he has to negotiate, all uphill to the flag. And one of his problems is going to be off the shoulder of this front left bunker. It's going to sling his golf ball to the right. So that's what he's got to do. Straight up the green there from almost 7 o'clock, I suppose, if you said 6 o'clock was directly in the middle of the green. Now let's have a look at our bird's eye camera. You can see this little knoll that is just there where he's walking. That's going to sling the ball to the right. And then once it gets up to the second level, it'll go back to the left. So speed absolutely vital here. And he's elected to putt it. So it really depends what happens with his golf ball in the first couple of meters. If it stays along the grass, hugs the grass, in other words, that's a good sign. But if it starts doing a bit of hopping and bopping, it'll come up short.
Snow spank. Oh!
God. How the hell did that stay out?
Because when they hit him dead centre, and that was dead centre, they usually drop in.
Shit.
Now, Jack, the pin was out, that going. I think it was going slowly enough. It was travelling a bit. But he's got a fall.
Shit. Normally with the fiberglass flag, it's receptive to the ball, and normally it hits it, and that was dead center and goes straight in.
Let's have another look at it. It certainly was traveling. Oh, it just spun over the top. And Laurie cannot believe it. So now, Greg has this putt for his third straight Australian Open title.
This is no bargain either, up the slope. As Pat said, he's got to contend with that tier. This to win the Australian Open.
Again. On we go, as they say.
back to 17. And sinks that. And he does. So the playoff continues, but it was almost brought to an abrupt end. Lee Westwood cannot believe it. As it slams into the pin. And just bounces out. He's explaining to Greg now. Why is it so? As back they go to 17. Norman or Westwood? Who's it going to be? Stay with us. You'll see it all on 7.
Ladies and gentlemen, we do it all again, back to the 17. And sudden death until there's a result. 17-18 repeated. So I hope we've all got a picnic hamper. We could be here for a while.
And so it is back to the third playoff hole. So the players and the crowd head back down. It'll be to 17 once again. And the way these two holes are playing, Jack, is it fair to say that it's perhaps a playoff that could be lost and not won?
Yeah, I think so. Neither of these holes are birdie holes. So I think it's going to depend on someone hitting a really great shot, or as you quite rightly point out, someone hitting an errant shot.
And of course, there's another thing as this goes on and on. It's a case of keeping a concentration. There are a lot of distractions, the what ifs and the buggy rides and the crowd making a noise. It's very hard because there's such a long gap between sort of holding out on 18 and coming back. It's very difficult to keep your concentration, even though there is so much at stake. The other thing, all the gamesmanship and what have you, is you don't want to get to the playoff tee too early and be kept hanging about, or the other man leaves you there for 5 minutes.
It's interesting that Greg gets dropped off well back and then walks to the tee just to gain his composure. Whereas Westwood's been driven almost to the tee.
That's experience for you, I think, there from Norman. Get sort of walking again, moving.
Well, it's a bit like sometimes when you're riding in a golf cart and you're playing golf, I find that my concentration isn't as good as if I walk with a caddy.
I think it's very true. You get there too soon somehow, and you there's one of the things about sort of judging distance I've always found is quite much harder from a buggy because you haven't sort of walked up to it. However, he'll keep the honour. No more tossing at this stage. Crowd, of course, will be feeding back as well, not having had the advantage of motorised transport.
He's going with 3 wood again.
As he attempts to win his third, it's interesting to note that Aussie Pickworth won his third straight in a playoff.
Against who?
Just checking now, Jack.
Probably Norman Von Nader or Eric Kremen or someone like that, was it? Anyway, here's Norman.
3 wood for Greg again, Jack. No luck so far on this hole. Just a couple of metres, 4 and 5 metres to the right, and he's found the light rough and the heavy rough at his last two tee shots here. Assisting with the 3 wood.
Come on, Greggy!
Shouldn't be happy with this behind the flag. Yep, now let's see if this hangs on. Hasn't kicked off a swale this time, and it's on the fairway.
He's still going to have to negotiate those trees, though, Pat. Now, this is an interesting play. He's elected this time to go with the iron from the tee, which is the club he selected during the normal course of the 72 holes. Hit the wood the last time, but now he's back with the iron.
He's back with the iron, Jack.
Get him in, Lee!
It's coming down the middle. Down the middle of the fairway.
Come on, Greggy.
Just going to finish on the upslope here. He's some 25, 30 metres behind Greg. But still on the fairway, but probably with about 185 metres to the flag from here.
So as they head down to play their seconds on the third playoff hole, we shall take a break and be back with their second shots. Welcome back. This is the third playoff hole, the second shots for Lee Westwood and Greg Norman, with a reminder that 7 News follows the outcome of this playoff. Westwood to fire first.
Westwood with a 7-iron. 185. It's got to go. It's got to hang in the air. Stay a little longer. It's on the just left of the flag. Great shot from here. He actually surprised me there. He took iron again off the tee. So he's gone iron, wood, iron the last time he's played this hole.
I'll tell you what, he's left himself almost exactly the same putt as he had for second time round. So you'll know both strength and direction.
Well, as we said, if you're on the right half of this fairway, those trees obscure your view. And Greg just trying to really get a handle on what the correct line is. I remember last time round, well, he's a little bit further to the right, he put it in the right-hand trap. So he wants to make 100% sure that he's got the right line in mind. Pat Welsh, what distance and club has he got here?
148 metres. That was the advantage of taking the 3-wood and keeping it in the fairway. And let's see if we can get a better result than his last two attempts here. 9-iron, Jack. Breeze helping and over his left shoulder. Floating again, he's trying to take it straight at the flag, and he's found the trap again. Front trap, this one, so a tougher shot.
He has a considerably more difficult shot, this one, because he's coming, instead of coming up the slope from the back bunker, which is on the left-hand corner of your screen, he's coming downhill, and it's longer and altogether more complicated.
Jack, I can tell you that it was Jim Ferrier that Ozzie Pickworth beat in, Pickworth beat in 1948. It was at the Heath. In fact, they played a couple of rounds on the Saturday. There was no play on the Sunday. Then they played an 18-hole playoff on the Monday. So as the boys make their way down for their third shots, Greg not thinking about this at the moment, but he most certainly will be come February. That is the Holden Greg Norman International. That's being played at the Australian course in Sydney early next year, starting on February 5 and culminating on Sunday the 8th of February. Just check your local guides though for details for that one. And then the following week, it's the Ericsson Australian Masters as we return to Huntingdale, where once again, Jack, as we always know,
the tradition will continue.
February 12 through 15. And if you look further ahead, an opportunity to be a part of the President's Cup in Victoria. The number to ring is 9809-0777. Whilst in other states, and bear in mind this other state's number is an office hours number, Monday to Friday, 9 to 5, 1-300-300-756. It's going to be quite a piece of history, the President's Cup. Greg Norman's playoff record on the US Tour, interesting, he's won 4 and lost 7.
Here's the shot that he's got. A much quicker shot than the first one. Not, I wouldn't call it a difficult bunker shot, but given the circumstances, this one brilliant shot.
Wonderful to watch. Well, I've got my full.
Yes. It's finished almost directly behind the hole. You can see where he comes from.
So now, pressure just changes ever so slightly as we look at it once again, Jack.
Yeah, notice the open stance, flexed knees, no big almighty swing, just a nice controlled swing. Beautiful shot. Yeah, this is quite similar putt to the one he had the first time around, Bruce, wasn't it? We know
well,
it.
Well, the sort of the second time if you take
the
hole.
Yeah, the first time round in the playoff holes.
Yes, that's right. It's absolutely it's the same distance, same line. So break from right to left to start with and then probably go back from, well, certainly go back a little bit from left to right by the hole. A great chewer of his tongue at critical moments. You've probably got horses to do that, haven't you, Jack?
The wrong time usually is. This to win the Australian Open. Well, that one didn't come back at all. Stayed left.
Onwards and upwards.
So now patience is becoming a factor. I think they've both had enough of this. Up and down like a yo-yo down 17 and 18.
Off to 18 now. There's the tongue problem. Well, it's not a problem, it's a trait.
My dog does that.
When he's putting.
Can he putt?
He can do everything else, but he can't do that.
Now, here's a chance to improve your putting with the magnificent little green reader screensaver. If you've got a computer, then you can fire this up and it'll just carve shots off your score. Exclusive to Seven Sport, it's a special limited edition offer of the great new green reader screensaver, and it can be yours for just $29.95. Bruce is converting that into pounds as we speak. That 15 quid. Call 1-800-151-777 now and order yours, and as they say, you'll be putting like a pro in no time. That is the Green Reader screensaver.
Nearer 12 quid these days.
Yes, it is, I suppose, isn't it? So we move to the 18th, the fourth playoff hole.
There's a fair bit at stake here for Greg because while he won't be thinking about it, Gary Player's won 7 Australian Opens, Nicholas 6, and Greg currently has won 5. He'll be the only one to win 3 in succession. And he'll join his mate Jack Nicklaus with 6 Australian Opens if he can win. Serious in there. There's his ball. Well, it's far enough back in the trap, I think, that he can get it over the lip. Any further up the bunker, and the lip would have impeded the ball flight.
Yes, he's about 180 metres from the pin, there or thereabouts, but it's not the position of choice, let's put it that way. Starting down the left side, fading back, looks in good shape. Just waiting for one of these guys to make a mental error. Somebody's going to get tired very soon. First time he's hit the fairway.
crowd certainly hasn't left Metropolitan. It's still this wonderful shot looking back down 18.
It's a brilliant finishing hole, isn't it, for such a big championship. It's got the space. It's a great venue for a big championship, Metropolitan. Beautiful old clubhouse, plenty of room here, good practice facilities.
With a freshly exposed wood by the look. Look at it, there's the
security guy saying, look, you've already broken one branch.
Get out of there before you break your neck.
Yeah.
Tell you, looking at that wider picture from behind the green there, putting is going to be more difficult this time round because the big shadows come across the green. You can see it there, and well, you're all right from this end, but putting in and out of shadows always makes judgment of line and pace difficult, or more difficult.
Just a reminder for those people who may have tuned in late, you'll not miss the news. It is going to follow the golf. We'll be staying with the Holden Australian Open until either Lee Westwood or Greg Norman is the champion for 1997. It's Greg's ball in that trap.
It's not the world's best lie. You can see a little bit of sand there up behind it. And that's the shot he's got. It's a tough, tough shot. But with his strength and the ability to hit the ball high that Greg Norman has, probably not as difficult for him as other mortals.
No, but as I think you said before, up that side, if you go in that bunker, it's got perhaps the steepest face of any bunker here at Metropolitan. And although he's well back, it's a little bit marginal. He's got to hit a perfect connection with the sort of club he's going to have.
Fiancé Laurie still keeping a close eye on proceedings via one of our cameras.
Well, we're getting to the time of year that, depending on the result, it can affect the quality of the Christmas present, can't it?
Most definitely. First prize, $189,470. Second prize, some $82,000 less than that, $107,370.
Shot from the green, looking back down to where Greg Norman's golf ball is in the bunker. And Pat Welsh, what's he got?
184, Jack, and Tony's just told me it's a 5-iron. Brett Hogan went over and had a very close look at it, and he said where the ball has run into the bunker, there's a little more sand just on the right-hand side of the board, so it means he's going to have to clip it absolutely perfectly. Now, he finished in this trap on Friday, but he was a lot closer to this lip and couldn't make it to the green, but he is further back today, and certainly with a 5-iron in his hand, he has every intention of giving it a crack at the green. 184 metres.
Whether he can get it back there with that club.
He's cleared the lip and he started it down the right half, and it's starting to work back towards the green now. This is a very, very good golf shot.
That's a great shot. Almost identical position to where Lee Westwood was in the normal course of play, Bruce.
Yes, first time round. So again, as Westwood had to do with him, he's at least asked the question. And Westwood now wasting no time.
162, straight down breeze. 7-iron. Starting it at the camera tower, it's hanging right. It's heading for straight at Greg Norman's golf ball.
Danced around it in the process. And the advantage margin is so with Norman, because he'll have an opportunity to see. Still going.
Ball has dropped back just a little down the slope.
Better run up and mark it. A couple more rolls, it'll be back down on that bottom tier.
Let's have another look at the second shot of Greg Norman coming out of the sand, Jack.
Yeah, the important issue here is don't let your body drop, so you hit the sand first. Keep your plane. Don't try and hit it too hard and make sure you get the ball first. That's a brilliant shot from there. 180 odd metres from the trap. That's a great shot.
There one say it's beginning to have another look of playoff hole number five.
Do we have a time limit? It's darkness set in. Well, as you say, patience is going to become a key factor. I don't think this crowd have it any other way at the moment. They can't get enough.
Well, it's an encore every time, isn't it?
Well, I think it's just that people like seeing head-to-head golf, and that's what this has come down to. Well, that's what we suggested it was going to be all day. Look at the fantastic crowd who stayed around to watch it, and then there's a few more thousand over the other side of the Holden marquee and the scoreboard watching it on the big screen.
Whichever, it'll be Lee Westwood to putt first. He's not now coming straight down the line of Norman's putt. It's downhill and right to left. Again, not that dissimilar to the one he had before.
Let's look at the green reader. That's roughly where Lee Westwood's golf ball is. It's got a little bit of the ridge to contend with, and it's going to definitely go from right to left at the cup.
Well, Jack, what are the odds on one of them holing this time, do you think?
Pretty slim.
Yes, they don't select pin positions on 18s with a view to lots of people getting birdies at the final hole of a big championship.
He's got to aim this almost out where his caddy's feet are. Has he hit it? Well, it got there, but it was always on the low side.
If I was him, I might have knocked it in.
You can see, as Bruce said, with the shadows, Greg got his hands shielding his eyes so he can try and get a mental picture of the line. Okay. I think that's about where his ball is. Might be a little bit more to the right, but it's going to go right to left, as did Lee Westwood's. I always reckon good putters have got terrific imagination to see the line. And this is the sort of putt, if you get up there and you're confident of you've got the right line, you can go ahead and hit it on the line. But if you're not sure and there's a bit of doubt, you never seem to put the same stroke on it. You can almost see a track into the hole when you're on the right track.
This is for the championship, Jack.
Well, he hit a pure putt. It was only speed that beat it, I think. A little bit softer and that would have taken the bar up.
Well, at least it's the shorter version of the one he had in normal time. Here's a picture there of dead still and the head just coming up after the ball is on its way. Break, it says.
Now, I hope he learnt from his first, or his 72nd hole. He doesn't want to give the hole away here. It looks like it should move from left to right, but it's pretty straight.
Of the first one, but it didn't look, it wasn't a pretty putt. This, the Australian Open Championship.
Boy, this 18th green is dead set giving Greg Norman nightmares.
Westwood is the Holden Australian Open champion for 1997 after a titanic struggle.
Well, he has not enjoyed playoff in 1997, has Greg Norman, but all credit to Lee Westwood. He stuck to his task all day long. He didn't catch Greg Norman until the 72nd hole. Well, Pat Welsh is down there with him, and he's going to get a word after a little bit of congratulations from the...
What about that for attention? A tear in the eye.
Yeah, that was hard work. I actually said to Greg's caddy on 15, when I held out, I said I've got three more holes till the end of the year. It didn't quite work out that way. I had seven, but, you know, I'll take it. It's great. Great to have won.
Talk us through, you know, leading up from the 70th hole onwards and then right the way through the playoff. What was going through your mind? Did you think you could win it at 70th?
I thought when I missed on 16, I'd blow my chance. But, you know, one of my pro-am partners said 17, 18, you know, they're real card wreckers. And, you know, you've only got to leak it right down 17 and you can get a bad line that rough there. And then anything can happen on the 18th going, you know, it's so fast from the right. You know, it's just a bit of a... We've got clouded vision at the moment.
A couple of three putts early in the day, and did you think to yourself, yeah, well, perhaps I've let this one slip?
Yeah, you know, I've got off to a bad start. Three putted the first, and then, you know, the wind switched on me on the fourth, and the 7-iron came up on the front when it would have comfortably got there, and a three putted that as well, you know. Just, I don't know what happened there. Just misread it.
Now, what about your finish to the year? Three tournament victories.
Yeah, I can't believe it. I finished first, second, first, 20th, first, the last 5 weeks, so... Yeah,
where do you put this one? Well, you've already spent quite a deal of time in Australia, haven't you?
Yeah.
You've got a lot of friends out here.
Yeah, I've got family out here. You know, I've never done well out here. I've always played less than average when I've come here. And then this week, you know, I've come on a roll and I was playing great coming in. And, you know, I've managed to keep it going. And, you know, to beat the world's number one in the playoffs, you know, it's a great finish to the year. You can't write fairy tales like that.
Now, you were talking about a Christmas present and maybe a plane if you could win three towards the end of the year. Are you going to buy yourself a plane?
Yeah, well, I said the last three and I finished 20th last week, so, I mean, that's out the window. So I'll have to think of something else.
Where do you rate this one?
Oh, this is... You know, it's difficult to rate them all, but your last one is always at the top of the list because it's the one you remember the most, especially when you're still on the last green. But as I say, to beat Greg in a playoff... You know, it's just a dream come true, really.
Well, there's celebrations to be had. You've beaten the great champion. You are the new Australian Open champion. Lee Westwood, congratulations.
Thank you. Thanks.
Yes, well done to Lee Westwood, the Holden Australian Open champion. As Pat said, a shaky old start to his final round, Jack, but it's all come together at the end, but not before a mammoth playoff.
Great effort. He's got a huge future, and... Most importantly, not only is he a good player, he's a good bloke.
What a way to finish the year with three tournament victories. Yeah. Fiancé Laurie, delighted.
So there he is, the young lion of world golf, rising star, hugging his fiancée Laurie, Laurie Coulthart, and Pat Welsh is on the 18th green with Laurie now.
Now, I hope I haven't caused a... We're just getting some final working out here for the presentation. Speech. I hope I, the speeches. I hope I haven't caused a family dispute here. Laurie doesn't want to speak. She said she gets very nervous
very
in front
nervous
of the camera.
Nervous and shy, yeah.
You were very tense out there. I know that, weren't you?
Oh, you can't help but be tense about that. I mean, shaking all the time.
You've got to be very proud. The performances over the last few weeks have been phenomenal, haven't they?
Out of this world.
Absolutely. Okay, best of luck. I've got a winning.
We'll be heading back to the presentation shortly, but Jack Newton joins me now. And Jack, obviously one of the finest Australian Opens of all time.
Well, there's nothing like a playoff, is there, to add a bit of spice to our number one event on the Australian golf calendar. And what a terrific tournament it's been. We suggested start of the day that it was a two-horse war, and it ended up a real war, didn't it, with all those playoff holes. A terrific win for Lee Westwood. He's got a huge future. Good attitude and a good golf game.
Now, you made a big thing of the Greg Norman putting on the 18th green, of course, Metro in 1979, and it's all come back to him. How do you think he'd be feeling?
Oh, he'd be down. He'd be really down, because it was a bit of deja vu, I thought, because I called it when he hit it. I said, gee, he's in the same place, and almost identical thing happened.
Big future for Lee Westwood?
Absolutely. I think he's got an enormous future.
Well, thanks very much for that, Jack. And Greg Norman at 14 under with Lee Westwood.
This has been a Seven Sports production.